Levallois, Paris is the scene for the 24th Acrobatic Gymnastics World Championships. The venue where it all happens, the Palais des Sports Marcel Cerdan. The people in the hall are ready, but we return to history. Nicolas Vleeshouwers and Laure de Breyck, Belgian gold medal winners at the last World Championships in Orlando, Florida, will not defend their title in Levallois. And they have a good reason. Both gymnasts got a contract at Cirque du Soleil.
They really teach us to entertain people and to enjoy it yourself too. And I think I really like this because in competition too, we had to perform, but it was more like points and judges, and now it's just people who come to watch you, and I think it's really nice.
It was nice to learn the cues where you have the chance to get in your character. It's really something else than just do this move, it's like you have to feel what kind of character you are.
I like to do the makeup. It's really nice to have to create a totally other face. Yes.
It's a really nice experience to get after a competition, do something really different but still in the same style. It's a good opportunity to do what you like to do.
So the big question is, who will be the world champion of 2014? Some say Russia, with Marina Chernova and former world gold winner Revaz Gurgenidze is a good bet.
You can't explain that feeling that when you're standing on the podium and you sing the national anthem, so for me it cost a lot. And you already forget the, all of the your power that you sacrifice by the being together with the families. And it's really hard.
Maybe the gold will go to Russia, but they will first have to beat the other favorites. Great Britain is one of them, and the United States, who have Ryan Ward on the floor, a highly experienced athlete.
My goal is gold. That is what I'm here to. That is what I'm here to achieve. So.
That's an honest answer.
Yeah, it's honest. Yeah, I mean, of course, there's great athletes on the floor, and everyone is fantastic here. We've all, as an athlete, to athletes, we know what it takes to get to this point in time. We know how hard it is to get to this point in time.
So we can look forward to an exciting mixed pairs final in Paris. Eight contestants in this final for the mixed pairs. Belarus, China, Ukraine, France, Great Britain, United States, Belgium, and Russia. Yun Yunchen and Wenhui Wu for China. We don't see them very often in major competitions, such as World Cups or international tournaments, the Chinese. So it's always a bit of a surprise. Eighth place after the qualifications, so will they play for the medals? Probably not. Nice first dynamic part. Perfect transition into a handstand. One-armed. There we go, to the arch. No mistake so far for the Chinese. Double tuck over the head. Some more balance elements now. This is sort of a ring. This is extremely difficult. Clean routine so far for this Chinese pair, Yun Yun Chen and Wen Hui Wu. The difficulty of 11 points. Three, they had a decent combined routine in the qualifications, but definitely not the highest difficulty. A split of the base. And in the background, we saw Team Belarus enjoying the Chinese routine. First place, 27.850. Alexander Spin and Elisaveta Vasilyeva preparing for their final routine. Ukraine went to the finals after a seventh place in the qualification round. First balance part. Split for the base and the arch on one hand. Seems a bit shaky from time to time. Double pike. So great first balance and dynamic parts. And they go to the ring immediately. Stable position. Transition to an arch or a Mexican. Great routine so far. But will this be enough to qualify for a podium place? That is the big question. Double pike, and this is the end of the routine for Ukraine. Elisaveta Vasilyeva and Alexander Spin. Here's the moment when she he goes to the ring. Alexander Spin and Elisaveta Vasiliga, second place, 27.765 for Ukraine. Dominic Smith and Alice Opcott. And let's make things clear. These two gymnasts are candidates for the podium, for the medals. Second place after the qualifiers. Arch ring. Britain, Russia and Belgium will be their biggest competitors tonight. And Alice are the European all-round champions. They took the title last year in Portugal. And they won the World Cup in Ireland in Germany. Silver medal at the World Cup in Portugal. If you see them on the floor, it'll look so easy. But this is amazingly difficult. What a flexibility. Transition to the Mexican. And back with the 2 feet on the ground. Alice Opcott and Dominic Smith. This be good for a first place. We'll know that in just a few moments. Here's that over arch. That's more a kind of a ring. An over ring or so. First place, yes, they did it. 29.520. That is the score that has to be beaten for the medals now. And now it's time for the competition of Great Britain. Before the start of these World Championships, they said that they we're going for gold here in Paris. They qualified for the finals only as fourth. Fortunately for them, they have a combined routine for the final with an extremely high difficulty. As you can see here. combination of balance elements. What a beautiful routine so far. Time for a tempo element. They won the World Cup in Portugal with a difficulty of, listen carefully, 13.600. For the United States, 29.520, that is the result to be beaten by them. Look at this, so beautiful. $29,360, no gold medal for the United States here, is Sergei Tretiakov, coach of the Belgians. Solano Casamayor and Jana Vastavel. Went to the finals after third place, and you might want to watch this routine because of its very original choreography. There comes the arch from Jana. Perfect so far. Nice catch. Look at the expression. The ring. Belgium. Solano Casamayor and Jana Vastavol. A lot of people thought that a podium place would be very difficult for them, but after the first qualifying rounds, they had the third place, beating even gold medal candidates Ryan Watt and Kylie Boynton from the United States. Third place, 29.315. Here's Russia with Revaz Gurgenitse and Marina Chernova. Revaz is a living legend. They were the leaders after the qualifications. Did a brilliant qualifying round, beating both the United States and Great Britain. Highest difficulty of all the combined routines. Revaz is already a base for more than 10 years. Two times world champion. Will he take his third world gold medal ever? Handstand split for the top. Silver medal at the European Championships last year in Portugal. Arch. Transition to a ring. This balance part of the combined routine. Back to the arch. Great work. Revaz Gurgenitse and Marina Chernova, 29.520. That is the result to beat in order to be on the podium as gold medal winner. He didn't succeed 2 years ago in Lake Buena Vista. And he kisses the floor here in Paris. Now in Lake Buena Vista, he had to be happy with a second place silver medal. Russia was beaten by Belgium. And a fantastic mixed pair, Nicola Vleeshouwers and Laura de Breijk. Who are now working for one of the FIG partners, Cirque du Soleil. World champions, 29.610. They did it. The third gold for Revaz Gurgenitse. Beating Great Britain. With just a little bit. And he's crying. He's so happy, Revaz Gurgenitse. Probably the most famous acrobat in the world. And here's the final standing. Gold for Russia, silver for Great Britain, and look at the difference. And the third place Bronze medal goes to the United States. Fourth place for Belgium. And with this medal award ceremony, ladies and gentlemen, we can end this final. Thank you very much for watching.